This is what I'm staring at right now on Panoptic. Those are all big fish. I want to get a big one, you know?
Yep.
Yeah. Cool.
Oh, that's bigger than 10.
Yes! Oh!
Let's go! Oh, look at this. Anyone can see this. Them's schoolers. Them's shad. Let's catch them.
What is up, MFers? Welcome to today's video. I got Swole Slaw, the ripping camera guy, right back there. And look at this, guys. We got giant swim baits. We got some prototype stuff I can't show you. We got top waters, we got dragon baits, we got deep crank baits, we got everything. I don't know what the hell we're gonna throw today, but we're at a new lake that has donks in it. Big fish are the goal today, and really any fish. I just need to rip some. Fishing's been kind of tough here in Texas, but I think some fish are finally starting to move out offshore. But who knows, we might be throwing for some skewers, we might be throwing for some frogfish up there in the grass. It's a great time of the year. It's gonna be a warm day today. Hopefully add to our double digit. I don't know, if we're lucky enough, we're gonna add to our four double digits and get number five for the year. They live in here, right here. Let's try to catch something.
Five of them followed it in, but it had a pound of grass on it. Come on out, big girl. That's a big one. Definitely was at least a six, but might have been way bigger. All right, okay. It's not a big one, but one of the first points we hit coleslaw. Deal. Dirty little swimming bait chewer. Catches them all, not just the gigantors. Freaking hooks got him, dude. Hit him with the hook set, launched him out the water. Poor little guy. He was coming off never. This is not the target size for the day, but if I'm gonna catch one like that size, 2.5, 3 pounds, it might as well not be on a damn Ned rig, right? Deal. Getting her started, Slaw.
Oh, they're busted. I thought that might get them going a little bit. Damn, they move fast.
Oh, yeah. Just had to tell them, Slaw.
We were fishing the bank, trying to get them off. Whew. We're fishing by the bank on some of these points, trying to get the little offshore bite going. We look out to the middle of the lake. We got these guys blowing bait, but I think there were some bigger ones mixed in too. So, little catwalk out there.
Cool. Got him. Yes.
Ooh, that's an idea. He's at least mad. Yeah, it's a slightly better one. Okay, we found some schoolers out here, Slaw. Woohoo! Yes, son. Look at that. He ate it with his head and his tail. Wow. Thought he was bigger, but they're just pissed off. Dude, there's hundreds of them out here. Not a giant, but I love it, man. This is fun. It's like, where do you even cast?
Everywhere.
Just start firing. I was gonna say, there's a bunch like close. Oh! There was one right there, Cole.
Got him. Got him. God, they jump and eat it. It's like, oh, that's a 6 pounder right there.
6 incher, actually.
That's why we need Chad in our pond, Cole. Got him.
hooked them funky. Nope. They're just pissed, Cole. Just little dudes, but man, this is crazy. They're blowing up everywhere around us here. There's got to be some big ones mixed in somewhere. Cole says numbers game. I'm going with him. This bait is perfect for these schooling fish because it's super loud and it stays real horizontal in the water column, so you can work it super quick. And when you got schooling fish like this, you want to keep it moving and keep it moving away from them, because a lot of times, you know, they're chasing the real thing, obviously. So you work it slow and methodically like you usually would around like an ambush point or something. A lot of times they'll just kind of, sometimes they'll eat it like that, but when you just skipping across the water, that's when they go, especially the big ones, which we haven't found. Got him. We'll let him cool off for a couple hours. Kobe. That's all I got, Cole. Oh, you're so mad. They keep shrinking, Cole. Oh god, that was awesome. It's always like the next fish you see up there. That one gotta be a big one. If you got one on, you can't cast to it. Or the ones that are just too far to cast to. Oh, those are big out there. Big ones need to get out here and do this. That one's giant. 6-7 inches. Oh yeah. He don't miss. He don't miss, Cole. Ah! Like I can. No! Oh. Yeah, buddy. Get him, Slaw! Dirty. Yeah, just a little belly on him. He's got a freaking ate an entire school of shad before you there. A bass fish.
Schooling bass heads.
You bet.
This is fun.
Why not? Went in this lake.
So we finally found a spot that doesn't just have the little 1 to 3 pound schooling fish in it. I'm seeing giant fish on panoptics everywhere, and right when we pulled up here, shad, big shad, giant shad started flying out of the water, everything just destroying it. But that little walking bait isn't quite enough attention to get on these fish when they're chasing these giant gizzards. So I think I'm gonna tie this big bait on right here to mimic those giant shad. This is another one from my buddy Victor Depp. Shout out to you. That I also caught some on his glide bait the other day, that paperweight it's called. And this is a giant walking bait with a huge presence in the water, glides real far side to side and throws a ton of water, kind of like a pencil popper or something like that. Maybe this will get us a bigger bite out here, but I'm still gonna throw the big swim baits around because that's what they're eating and they are everywhere. The one I caught, I actually thought it might have been shad because it looked like a half or quarter of the size of some of the marks I'm seeing on the screen. There's legitimate 10 pounders right here. Just gotta make them bite.
God, some chads just f-ing died.
Oh.
So biggins, huh? Yeah. It's happening. Oh, those are giants, dude. Oh my god. There we go. There we go. Yeah. Dropped it in there to him. Boom. That, I cannot believe this, dude. There was like a bunch of these little guys, big school of them. They went thung on the little swim bait. I thought he was for a second, but deal. Little 3 pounder, can't hit that, Slaw. Swimming baits, huh? Right back to his buddies, man. They're loaded here. We just moved to a little offshore point. Saw some big ones on it, and then I saw a school of shad
getting pushed, start flying out of the water. They're all 8 to 10 inch shad.
Giant.
These ain't the little schoolers.
This is what I'm staring at right now on Panoptics. Those are all big fish. I don't know if they're all giant ones, but like some of these giant blobs up here, you can see there's a nice little drop off and hard bottom through here, and giant shad keep rolling through. God, look at some of those fish out there. Big, solid returns.
Those are big, so I gotta get in there.
I can't wait any longer, Cole.
I got bit 3 times on that cast.
Eat it. See my rod?
This is nuts, dude. We're staying all night. 3 in the morning. We're gonna be out here. Becky's gonna think we're dead. Maybe we will be. Who knows? From excitement.
If this doesn't work, I'm gonna try a hollow belly. I'm thinking maybe smaller profile. They're so hot that I think you could get them to stick on something. They're just bumping it. They can't really bump that smaller 5-inch bait. But it also might not have as big of a draw power and as natural a swim as that, so you never know.
Always these damn decisions.
Big old Chad school just rolled by him out there.
Bigger bait, bigger fish.
He liked the way that tasted. He liked the way that tasted, coleslaw. Making that switch up.
In your grill, Cole.
In your grill! Let's go. Wanna how big that bait is right there, Cole? It's 7 inches.
Well, it was.
It was, now it's gone. Never mind. Made a bait adjustment. Not a giant, but man. Look, it used to, there's his eyeball. That's what the bait used to be. This is it, dude. I thought I would downsize. Just threaded a little tiny eyeball on a piece of plastic on the hook. And that's all it took. Now Timmy's gonna move in on us. This is just a baby fry out here though. Let's get another one.
A lot of shad deaths going on down there right now, coleslaw. That I can promise you. Got enough for a video. I just wanna get a big one, you know?
Yep. Oh, it's 10 pounder.
Need you, Cole.
Yep. Oh, oh.
Hold on, take your time. Take your time. That's bigger than 10.
Yes! Let's go!
Just need a bigger
Boom!
One.
Boom!
Dude. Let me lift that one up.
Boom! Yes! How long is that some bitch, coleslaw?
27.
Oh, yeah!
I just popped the hook out. It was barely in the gill. I think she's doing fine. Mm-hmm. There's so many of these in this spot down there right now, guys. She bit just like the ones that have just been dunk, 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 just barely bumping it. We gotta get her on a scale.
That's big. That's
get her back long. In the lake. That's a long, long fish.
Woo. Give me some, Gina. Boom.
Okay, just to make it official, zeroed out on the scale. Of course it doesn't then. Zeroed out on the scale. It's bouncing so much. She's right at. Can you see it?
Yeah.
What is it, 10.02?
10.06.
10.06. All right, we don't want to hang this fish like that too long. That's amazing. Oh, what a beautiful fish. I'm gonna dunk her quick. Important to keep these fish like this in the water. She was in the live well for a couple seconds. Want to see a length on her real quick, coleslaw?
Yes, please.
Let's put her on there, see how long she is without someone rolling in on us.
That gum freak.
That was pretty darn close.
Mouth shut.
Come up to 27
inches. 26 and three quarter.
That's longer than Joe's, right?
Same, exact same.
Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness, and one just blew up back there.
That a big flop.